Greetings, everyone. I'm Mr. Mocha Lover, and thank you for rejoining me here in... I almost said Old World Blues, but Vanilla Hoi4, in which we're playing as Turkey with Atatürk. So, let's talk about decisions immediately, because it's June 15th, 1937. We currently have a faith tax, which we need to remove soonish, because, well, it's hurting our stability and war support. That being said, there's a couple things that we got to do in this episode, and we also have to entrench Kemalism in the state. So, yesterday, I said we should probably keep Atatürk, but off-screen, I sought treatment for Atatürk, and it costs us 200 political power here. If you do this again, for 120 days, it'll have his condition, or deteriorating condition. If you keep doing that over and over again, as far as I found out, because it took a while to do, he doesn't get any better, I think, because the first cost is 200 here, 200 political power, the next cost is 275, the next cost is 300-something, and we don't have that type of political power, so honestly, I just don't think we can keep Atatürk, which is really, really disappointing, since I want him to lead Turkey, but I think it's time to retire him, just because at 200, it's not really worth it for the cost. Let's see, when selected, we get minus 30, well, actually, for this one, when we selected, we lose stability, and we get a national spirit, Mustafa Kemal Atatürk, which still gives us some buffs, but if we wait, well, nothing really should hurt us, right? So, we got 102 political power. Let's go ahead and entrench Kemalism in the state because we want to have Kemalism everywhere. And let us continue. We will be offering conscription exemptions to the Kurdish groups because the Kurds are very upset with us. Go figure. And we also have to repeal the faith tax and other things, but we're not quite there yet then. Right now, we have no fuel, which is, could be worse. Could be worse. We're right now cooperating with the debt council for more political power. And then we change to free trade for more construction speed, research speed, and output, even though it hurts our resources. But besides steel and a lot of chromium, wow, we output a lot of chromium. Wow. We don't really have any other resources. So it's 1937. And currently we are focusing on battleships, which is cool. Let's grab... Oh, we have this done. Nice. We already got a lot of this stuff done for battleships. However, we want this... We want to think about radar maybe a 2 degree as well, but we got to wait till 38. Ooh, maybe. We got some artillery. We do have anti-air 2 already, so if that's going to be the case, I suppose we can wait until we have radar 2. Or, you know what, how about we don't wait? We're going to research basic fire control systems, and then we're going to throw that on our ships. I don't ever use that, but we might as well try it, right? Try something else a little different from here on out. We're currently doing okay on factories. Actually, that's not too bad. 15-1. At least it's 15-1 instead of 15-0. And you know what? At this point, we're just going to save up at this time to get rid of the faith tax because I do not want to lower my stability anymore. I don't think it'd be a good idea to lower our war support either. And we've got actually quite a few comments to get through next. For example, so we are not reforming the Ottoman Empire in this campaign. There is some support from the comments from the first video where people do want me to reform the Ottoman Empire. And I promise you, I will someday. I'm just not sure, but we have leadership purges in the Soviet Union. Very cool. Japan declared war on China, and we finished our little thing over there. I'm pretty much probably going to ignore the entire army branch here for a long, long time. Yeah, modernize our tactics. We get a bonus to land doctrine, which we might do, but there's 70-day focuses, and the vast majority of these are just blueprints. Maybe get 2 military factories and land forts. I do want to get down, though, to emergency deployment of defensive bases later on. Actually, it's only for 2 years now. Never mind. Disorganized armed forces. We'll get down there eventually, but that's going to take quite some time. So I'm not really going to focus on that. However, we could do the Treaty of Sadabad, utilize foreign capital, but we could probably save this for much later just because we can't come down here because we're not going democratic. We can't do privatized Anadolu agency. So instead, we shall do which one? Actually, we do this one first. We come down here, but I do want to get to Turk Ulusu. So the Kurdish rebels in Hakkari will be pacified. Let's go with the Treaty of Sadabad. We have nothing to lose and everything to gain by remaining friendly with our neighbors to the east. The idea of a treaty formalizing our friendship has been lobbed around on occasion, and it's high time for Turkey to take the initiative and make sure this friendship is codified into a treaty. Very good. And now we about absorb the TPDA. Ooh, an improved airplane catapults. Don't mind if we do. But it's still only 37, and we've got some time. Well, sometime. Let's grab engineers, because without engineers, why do you even use support companies? But the Turkish, what was it? The Turkish Public, what is it? Debt administration is fused into our industrial sector like a tumor. But we can reintegrate the organization as a national process in order to remove the debt administration as a hurdle to our further development. Cool. So we'll do that eventually. It hurts our stability. We lose barely any political power. And resources to the market goes up, which is nice. And we have industrial projects, which cost a lot, but there is a way to lower the cost, which is going to be kind of weird to do. Initiate counter-fundamentalist operations. States that are not aligned with us. Ooh, and we have retired Atatürk. Yeah, we'll do that soon enough. Let's see. Traditionalist infiltration. States that oppose the principles of Kemalism. Well, we don't want to do that. Kurdish rebels, if anything. I do want to get rid of these Kurdish rebels. What else do we have here? Marco Polo Bridge incident. Ooh, ideological crusader. Captain of industry is not bad. I do prefer the financial expert, though, right now. And if we can eventually get to this, but we need more war support first, which is fine. It'll take some time, but that's fine. Currently get 1.37 political power a day. Hopefully we can get some more Kemalism so we can crush this. We have 78 days left, which is fine. Oh, there it is. Entrench Kemalism in the state, just so that the traditionals don't get any more support here, which would be a good thing. Now, these blue lines, what do these mean? States that oppose the principles of Kemalism. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8... 8-ish, maybe? 7 to 8? That's not great. Now, of course, we have rebel groups here, too, but whatever. And we'll find... Wait. 99, 98? Does this keep going up? Huh. Regardless, so I asked you guys yesterday, too, Somewhat asked you guys whether we should do, like, join the Axis or take the Mediterranean Entente. Well, I realized... Actually, I tried to record this before, and I made a mistake. You can actually go down the Anglo-Turkish Agreement, as well as the German... Turkish Friendship Treaty, as well as renew the Soviet Non-Aggression Pact. You can do all those. There's quite a bit of support for me to go down the Mediterranean Entente. There's a little bit of support for me to join the Axis. And there is a little bit of support for me to join the Allies as well. So, even though there is more support for the Mediterranean Entente, we'll see how it goes. This is on Historical AI. So that being said, I have a good feeling we might join the Axis to help smash the Soviet Union. And then once we go through there, we can probably... create our own faction, and then backstab the Axis while they're fighting the Allies, maybe? But if we join the Allies, well, then we could probably just smash both sides fairly easily and then smash the Allies. Or just go with our own way and have everyone be really pissed off at us. Which we might do. I don't know. We'll probably go down, honestly, with the Mediterranean Pact, but I'm putting it out there right now. I don't know. Maybe, maybe not. We'll see what happens. Just because we'll see how far we can get with our military. Obviously, our military does not look very good right now. We're working on it, obviously. But we'll see what we can do. And let's start doing some superior firepower just because land doctrine is super, super important. We probably want to get... Yeah, we need to get a military theorist quickly, too. I forgot about that. Yeah, we definitely have to do that. Someone said, save the world from fascism and communism. We'll see what we can do. I don't know. I mean, we are non-aligned, and we're going to keep it that way for now, so... Yeah. Economic advisors. 127 is really not bad. Ah! So Afghanistan signs a sad and bad pact. Mohammad Zahir Shah was very enthusiastic when presented with our proposals for a treaty of friendship and a pact of non-aggression and wasted no time in getting back to us with their signatures on the treaty. With their agreement, we are one step closer to achieving peace at home and peace on the world. Or in the world. You shall always be a dear friend of Turkey. Great. And they're the only ones who signed, apparently. Oh. Next up. Let's scroll back up and assess our future. When Mustafa Kemal Atatürk liberated this nation and declared its independence, he did so with a very specific vision of what the Turkish state should eventually look like. The time has come to analyze whether the vision of our Ghazi still aligns with the priorities of the current administration, which we get the legacy of Atatürk, we get more stability, and a tiny, tiny, tiny bit more political power. Cool. Our choices on where to steer our country's ideological direction will reflect how well we are being perceived as living up to the ideals of Atatürk. Very cool. As well as Iraq, Ghazi I was very enthusiastic when signing it. It's pretty much the same thing. So, we shall always be a dear friend to Turkey. Iraq, good. And Iran, from Reza Shah Pahlavi. The Pahlavi family. Now that's awesome. Kurds, god dang it, Kurds, why do you have to be so Kurdish? Now, this would hurt us, but that's not bad. We have to do that eventually, so we can pay off our debts. But, I'm thinking first, we could do counter-fundamentalist operations. Kind of want to do that. Why is it so blue? I don't understand why it's so blue. Is it because we don't own this area? Or we got rebels here, maybe? I'm going to go ahead and do this. We're going to offer them, like we did yesterday with Ezerum, in Diyarbakir. We give them the conscriptions, exemptions granted. So, just because if we can court, we can stop wasting manpower. We get the factories that are in here as well, which are none. God dang it. So, if we court, even though... we don't get a lot of population from it. We don't have to waste manpower on this area, which will be a good thing. So we need two more as well. Has not completed focus piece at home. Oh. Well, whatever. We can wait on debt. I really just don't want to retire him. We lose 15% stability, and I don't want to do that yet. Reformism. We could do republicanism for more weekly stability, but that only happens for 2 weeks, which means you get 5% stability. Reformism isn't bad, but you get more daily democracy support. Plus 50% political power is not bad, but that's 75 political power to use, so that's a little expensive, man. A little expensive. I think next we'll do military theories, because we could definitely use some military stuff. We could definitely use some political power or army XP. What does this do? Counter the rebels. 82% chance of gets rebels defeat our forces in Hakati. 70% chance of rebels successfully countered. If there's 17%, that's not cool. That is not cool. 17%. No, no, no. I want to do this, but I think we want to ensconce some more Kemalism into our group here. And I've got to keep an eye on Atatürk's condition as well. I don't want him to leave. But god dang, just do it anyways. Choosing Atatürk's successor. No man or woman could ever hope to live up to the mythic heights of Mustafa Kemal Atatürk's leadership. But the father of the Turks remains but a mortal man. We are not looking to replace our Ghazi, for no one could ever dream to live up to our nation's messianic founding father. But we must choose a leader that we can trust to follow in Atatürk's footsteps. They must exemplify Kemal's values and follow Atatürk's example as the leader of Turkey. Celal Bayar is the obvious candidate, or Ismet Inonu is Atatürk's worthy successor. That was another comment from yesterday saying that it's very interesting how I'm pronouncing all these things, because I am not Turkish at all. I don't know anything about Turkish language and stuff like that. But someone said I should probably use a Turkish to English or Turkish to English dictionary. Probably should. So you get more stability with this guy, defense of core territory, justify war goal stems on us, and ideology drift defense. I like that stability, which is better than what this guy gets in terms of political power. But you get better trade deal opinion factors, improved relations opinions, which will come in handy later on, and ideology drift defense. I like that core territory defense. Improved relations, that's okay, we need to use that later on, but it's only 25%, and just spend more political power to have better relations opinion. That's not that much political power. Let's go with the guy with more stability. That just seems to make more sense to me, at least. So I'm so sorry, Atatürk. But now we're led by Mr. Mustached Dude. Oh, wait. Oh, was he the guy that gave me political power? Were you the son of the work? Oh, my goodness. I can get a prime minister. Daily command multiplier gain. Okay. Oh, who's this? Oh, so we unlocked some new guys. So earlier, we had this guy. We have a feminist ultra-nationalist. Sokka. Ooh, doi, doi, doi, doi. That's so good. Minus 5%. Vatan ideologue. 3-3-3. Ooh, who's this? Ruling party, revolutionary author. That looks not bad. That looks really good, actually. Fascist support, non-core manpower. Oh, this is really good. Has completed focus, propagate the doctrine of pan-Turkism. Oh my goodness. Plus more daily compliance and root out resistance mission effects. Academic. Prime minister, war support, that's okay. I like that this guy can give you better consumer goods and improve relations time or opinion. Oh, man. I want to do so much, but we don't have enough political power to do everything I want. Offer conscription exemptions? I think I'm going to save up for that Army XP guy. I think that'd be for the best, so. Oh, Atatürk, why? His whole elf is poor. He needs time to stay home with his family. He's got a family to think of his own. Why? Why can't people just live forever? Well, some people. Definitely some people. Not everyone. Oh, no, no, no, no. That would not be very good. But and also those other comments saying that they agree with me from yesterday's videos, like 70-day focuses. Come on, man! After we've been spoiled by Old World Blues and Kaiserreich and TNO, and even to a degree a little bit from TWR, the Thousand Week Reich, but still. But we're going to talk about the Hete issue. We can no longer sit idly by and allow the oppression of Turkish minorities by Arab irredentists and French imperialists. The notion that Hete is not every bit a rightful part of Turkey is ridiculous and to be dismissed out of hand as a revisionism. It is time to set right the mistakes of 1921. In which we get some more war support. Italy announces claims on Yugoslavian territory. A Hete issue, which I might be pronouncing that wrong. I apologize if I do, but military theorists, it is. I guess we got 2 slots now. That's kind of nice having that. I like this. Avid Tyrannist. That looks pretty cool, but we're not going a fascist route this time. Let's see. So it looks like there's no more calls, at least for now, for traditionalism. for traditionalism. It's almost 38 right now. I think at this point, I do want to get military hospitals, but I think we should be okay without getting that. We should get some armored cars because we're going to need them in the future. But let's get some better fighters because we need fighters. And guns. Fighters and guns. So next thing we'll be done is our land doctrine or the superior firepower so we get some more soft attack. I love soft attack. Oh man, we need army XP so I can start using some artillery in our infantry battalions or infantry divisions to replace battalions because, well, you save guns, you save manpower when you switch these out with artillery. Which would be good. Should be very, very good. And my goodness, we just... I don't know anything about Turkey or the Turkish military, especially in the 30s. But, oh man, it's not looking great. It's not bad. Obviously, we could be Bulgaria. But it's not bad. It's not bad. We currently get 1.37. Still, not bad. Not bad. Republicanism, I mean, that's... For 25 political power, for 5% more stability, that might not be bad. Populism for 50, that's not worth it. For 8, was it, for 60 days, and you get weekly manpower set by 250. There's about, what, 8 weeks? 8 times 8 is 64, so it's, right, yeah. So it's not that much manpower, you get like 1500 to 1800, that's, for 50 political power, I'm not thinking that. Nationalism for 4 weeks, you get a whole total of 10% more, which isn't bad. 75 political power for 10% war support. Okay, I can kind of see that. But, oh. Oh, come on. Kurds. Guys, come on. I said this last time, too. Why can't we just be friends here? Just join the military and have a good time while we're doing the Hetay issue. Yeah, we should be able to get one of that done. And we're going to come over here so we can... So that in Hakkari and Van, the Kurdish rebels... In Hakkari, at least... We'll be pacified and we get some more war support because I want to get that done quickly. Part of being a responsible and modern country is being able to redefine what it means to be a citizen of said country. We've been too restrictive or strict on what it means to be Turkish, and to properly represent the makeup of our country, it is high time we expand the definition of what makes a citizen a Turk. That'd be kind of interesting. The Kurdish rebels in Hakkari will be pacified. I'm not sure what that's actually going to end up doing for us, but hopefully it'll do some good stuff. International collections, concessions. So France cedes sovereignty of Hatay to us. İzmit İnönü gave a small speech in Antakya, welcoming the citizens of Hatay into Turkey, and gave thanks to Leon Blum of France for respecting the democratic will of the people of Hatay. Even though the move was met with outrage by Syrian officials, oh boy, the general mood of Hatay and Turkey as a whole was one of satisfaction, and many Turkish people have made trips from their homes down to Hatay to consecrate Turkey's newest province with celebrations and gift exchanges. We welcome you back into the fold, brothers and sisters. Wow! 120 political power and become owner of this? And we get about 5,000-ish more manpower or so? Very nice. Very nice. That was worth it. I'd say that's definitely worth it. So, we're going to do whatever we can next. And Hakkari will be pacified. And Van, so it's over here, Hakkari and Van. What they want right now in Van, conscription exemptions, I want to go through here, this one first, and then we'll do stuff about that. So in the meantime, we shall instead, we can do that factory stuff, we're not going to do that yet though. What does it mean to initiate counter-fundamentalist operations? 92% chance the traditions will be more willing to cooperate with the government in Kayseri. I think now we have 7. Ooh. What do I do? Superior firepower, I'll do that. I like this just because it gives you political power and consumer goods. 5% though, that's pretty good, not gonna lie. But slightly, justify rogue sounds on us might be good, but it's on historical AI, or historical focuses. Improve relations opinion, we could still do that, because we do need to improve relations with the US later on in our focus tree, which we'll talk about later on. Ideological crusader, infrastructure, civilian factory construction speed. I'm just going to go ahead and choose financial expert, just because 15-4, that's better than 15-1, so. Nice. Happy 38, my friends. Happy 38. It's going to be a good year for us. Well, hopefully. Hopefully. At least he gives us more stability. And a little bit more defense on core territory, which will be very necessary when we fight the Soviet Union. Because we will fight them. We will fight them fortunately or unfortunately. And I don't want to forget, we got almost 600 pieces of equipment. Of artillery pieces, I should say. Computing a machine, plus 5%. Very good. Let's go ahead and throw some... battalions on here, like artillery. We have enough. We do not have enough. Oh my goodness. Wow. Okay, well, fine with me. Gives us a little bit more soft attack. Now we're out of guns, and we're out of artillery. Hmm. It is what it is. But this helps us out a little bit more, I would say. Hmm. Well, let's hope so. These are positive now. We're going to need to really focus on our military. Hmm. It's a good thing that Turkey didn't intervene in any side during World War II. But where we're going to be intervening pretty much everywhere in this campaign. How much longer do we have with this? Oh my god, Paradox, why are these 70-day focuses? Why? Do they not like the community? Well, they probably do a little bit. Maybe not a whole bunch. But maybe they do. I don't know. I don't get told anything. There you go. Make that 2. Izmir, you're over here. Do it some more. And then maybe start making some military factories. We gotta start thinking about that. 40%. There you go. We really gotta start doing stuff like that. Conscription exemptions. Yeah, whatever. Actually, how is that looking right now? Because we did core 2 areas, so. Let's see. Oh, wow. Vaughn. Oh, it's slowly going up. Hakkari is doing okay for now. Kurdish Rebellion, plus 35%. Over here, Kurdish Rebellion, plus 35%. Over here, High Compliance, Kurdish Rebellion, minus 10%. And same thing over here. But hey, we're getting out of that artillery deficit faster than anything else compared to our guns. Oof. Alright, so, now that we've done that, we're not going to do peace in the world because that would make no sense. We get some stability, we generate war goal tension limit plus 100%, which is not good. Join faction tension limit, 100%, not good. And more stability, which is, well, I mean, technically we get 20% stability out of that, but that's not really worth it. Really not worth it. So, we could do the Pontic Redoubt, which would give us factories. Give us land forts next to the Soviet border, but let's not do that yet. Let's go and do the Abuse Office of Soil Products. The Torprak Masulari Ofisi was founded to regulate the production of foodstuffs and wages of agricultural workers, but Turkey does not need farmers, it needs land. We shall pressure the poorly performing farm owners into selling their land so that new industry can be erected on those plots to benefit of the nation as a whole. Very good. Very good. And we might have 5 army XP, but we're going to save it for support artillery for our infantry. I'm not going to switch another battalion up yet, that just would not be very smart. It'd be kind of irresponsible. Even though, we might want to consider putting, actually, military police on these guys. We should probably do that, but we've got other things to do. It's 38. We only have 3 research slots, which really sucks. Acquiesce to the fundamentalists. For the Republic to survive, there must be compromise, even if that means subverting the constitution this nation was founded on. Should I do that? That's 200 political power. I have a feeling I shouldn't. We want to get rid of as much traditionalism, or at least a good amount of traditionalism. We want more Kemalism, right? So, should I acquiesce to the fundamentalists? Let me know in the comments below. In the meantime, though, because we did that stuff, and we just finished the whole thing with... Oh my goodness, now this is nice. No resistance, low resistance. Oh yeah, now we got those guys done. We're using cast as well. We got that going. Let's go ahead and grab... Do we finish everything here first? 39, 39, 39. I do want synthetic oil. Ship stuff, we've got to start thinking about ships as well a little bit more. We don't have enough dockyards to make cruisers. We're only going to be making battleships for now, but cruisers are much cheaper and easier to produce than anything else. In the meantime, we could go to partial mobilization, but here's the deal. We can only have Etatism, which is okay. It's not bad. It's kind of okay, especially for civilian factory construction speed. But we currently are in a civilian economy, so that hurts our construction speed. So if we do partial mobilization, we will eventually have to get rid of Etatism, and that's going to... We'll have a decision to take there. But that does decrease the political power needed for industrial projects by quite a bit. So, we got to make a choice. Ooh, because that 30% construction speed is killer. We're already halfway. Actually, it's not too bad. It's really not too bad, I suppose. Yeah, I mean, 15% civilian factory, but 5% for military factories? Right now, we're on, what, minus 30%. Compared to the plus 15 we get here, if we come down to partial mobilization, you save 10% consumer goods, as well as you basically get 30% bonus to civilian factory construction speed, and 40% bonus to military factory construction speed. This gives you just a little bit. So as much as we like Etatism, I've got to switch to partial mobilization for us. So now we're going to have a little bit of a problem once we get through a day and actually do this first. And we're fighters, we actually have some better fighters, thankfully. But do we not choose what we wanted here? Better artillery would be good to do. Let's go ahead and grab you so we get some more defense and breakthrough first. Alrighty, and devaluation of the Turkish lira. Trying to simultaneously maintain an etatist economy model while also adapting a war economy is proving to be problematic. Well, it's not a war economy, just partially a war economy. So if we don't complete this, if we don't go down and do abolish etatism, it was a glorious achievement of the Kemal system and a fruitful experiment, but unfortunately it is an experiment that might need to be shuttered permanently for the greater good, so we remove that spirit, because if we don't do that, we lose daily political power. We basically lose 2% more consumer goods factories and 15% stability. But if we complete this, we get 5% more stability, 50 political power. So really, we need to get up to 100 political power, spend 100 to get 50 back, 5% more stability, and not have to deal with that anymore. And if you look down here, we can switch these down as well. So that's the next thing we got to do. Abolish etatism. I don't know what this was like historically because I'm not Turkish, like I said before, but let's go ahead and do it. And we have devalued the lira. We got 5% more stability. Let's come down here. And look at that. 50, 50, 50, 300, 50, 50, 50. So, overall, I think it does save you political power. And this will hopefully benefit us more in the long run. Okay, they just already finished another civilian factory. Great. How long will this take? Until July 2nd? Not great, but you know what? Civilian factories take forever. And for this one, it'll be finished when? July 31st. So, in 2 months. Not bad, not bad, not good. I don't know. We'll see what happens. I don't think that's too bad, though, for us, really. That's probably not too bad. And, even though we could lose political power, we can start getting some civilian factories. That'll be nice, actually. I still want to offer this stuff, though. Do these guys have any factories? No, they have absolutely nothing here. Absolutely nothing, and yet they complain. But, hey, you know what? With us getting rid of their rebelliousness for now, our compliance can continue to grow, hopefully. 0.8. Doesn't look like it's really moving too much that fast. So we don't really have to do this yet, because we don't get anything from doing this. Do they even have, like, resources there? I'm not seeing a whole lot in terms of resources over there. So no, all we get is less manpower used to control those areas. So you know what I say? We could do some debt stuff. That'd be good. We don't have to do that yet, though. So, how we could construct some factories. We lose some political power, but whatever. Let's go ahead and grab this one. It's 50 political power. Ooh, this one is excavation 2 and synthetic oil experiments. Not bad. Stability 2. For if you do this, you lose 15% political power. You get 4 steel and another civilian factory. Let's do that. I like that one. And now we have that. We shall go ahead and figure out what we're going to do. So I said before, I don't want to do continue to the Balkan Authority or the Pact. Balkan Pact. Oh, reconfigure Turkish foreign policy. Turkish foreign policy has been focused on domestic affairs and keeping foreign policy interactions consigned mostly to our neighbors, but the times have changed and our foreign policy must reflect that. It is long time overdue that we started to deal with more with the major powers of the world. Get more political power, which would be nice. Bulgaria approaches the German Reich. They seek only Hitler's protection. Probably. I mean, they're a tiny, tiny nation. Very nice. Hey, we almost have 10 RMXP. Nice. Kemalist officers plus 5%. Awesome. 100,000 men in reserve. And I think we're only on volunteer only, so that's not too bad. I would like to get, is it ultra feminist, ultra nationalist? 2% population would not be bad, but we can't do that. Let's see. The Prime Minister. We already got the guy with 5%. Captain of Industry, because we do want to build some refineries eventually, as well as infrastructure. But 3% consumer goods. Actually, let's see. Look over here. 17% of civilian factories, or civilian and military factories, to produce consumer goods. Okay. Civilian and military factories, 31. Partial mobilization, stability, required consumer goods factories, 5. So, we'll see what happens. Hey, we actually made another division. Wow. I can't believe we actually made another one. Go ahead and train them. You guys are over there. So, defend against the Greeks. You never know what the Greeks are up to. Never know. Never, never, never know. I think we'll pay off... do we want to pay off the debt yet? Or more factories? Actually, we've got... Oh my gosh, that's 240 days. Jesus Christ. Oh my God. Oh, Jesus. Why? Why do you hurt me like this? Why do you have to have such super long decisions? Ugh, I just want to go to war, man. I just want to go to war. I guess we could put down one of the rebels here or something. We're not going to counter the rebels. Actually, 50% chance of rebels successfully countered. We get more compliance and less resistance, but you don't actually core them. So, what's the point? It's probably just better to core them, honestly. We could get more stability by coming up here. 25 political power for 5% more stability. Is that worth it? Not too much. Support weapons are nice, though. Let's grab some improved infantry equipment 1-2. That'd be good. Another division. Don't mind if we do. Beautiful. Train, if you need it. That'd be great. 1.09. Competing machine is awesome. We could get some radar, but we're going to wait on that. Let's grab some fuel storage, because we will want to build that eventually up. We definitely do. I keep forgetting about this. God dang it, Mr. Mocha Lover. What is wrong with you? A lot of things. Well, not too many things. I should have been producing this earlier, but we only have one dockyard, so it doesn't really matter that much. Radar, we're not going to have that. Fire control 3, because I almost never use that. Anti-air 2. Heavy battery 2. Heavy battery 2. Another heavy battery. Right, 30. That's not bad, actually. Doing that might be a little overkill. That's even more heavy attack. Actually, if we go with anti-air, that's not bad. Because we will be fighting a lot of planes, and it makes our ships a little bit faster. Heavy attack isn't bad, but heavy piercing. Damage done by the heavy guns. Heavy guns are better at targeting bigger ships. 2.4 is not very much. If we do that, though, that could really help out our anti-air. Because that's... I'm not worried about enemy ships so much as in any compared to enemy planes. Screw it, we're going to go with the bigger batteries, right? Oh, 27.8 speed. I don't want my guys too slow. Screw it, just do... I like the batteries. Cool. Awesome. Good luck making that. It'll be done in 54. So even if we didn't get to it last year, it doesn't matter, because we probably won't get to it anyways. At least yet. So, let's go ahead, and we can pay off the debt, but nah. There you go. Got one more done, so we don't have to waste manpower on this group anymore. And we got one more group down there. Could be better, could be worse. Beautiful. Reconfigure Turkish foreign policy. Immediately we shall do... Ooh, we get add technology basic medium tank. The treaty guarantee... guarantee independence. Renew non-aggression pact. If we do this fast, and if we can get two civilian factories, two infrastructure, a military factory, and two more infrastructure. Weekly manpower, weekly stability goes down. The agreement. 40 or more units of chromium will receive 3 levels of infrastructure and 2 factories. Ooh! Or we come over here, Iraqi oil or something like that, host exotic scientists. And here's the focus that requires us to have high relations with the U.S. The higher the opinion the U.S. has of us, the more likely the concession will be approved. Motor factories, that's not bad. Let's go with the German one first. It's only 35 days. Finally! The German Reich and we are natural allies. The German Reich and our natural allies? We do not have to see eye to eye on every issue, for our recent histories are not too all dissimilar. British efforts to control our foreign policy will come to a naught. We should prove that with a new treaty of friendship signed unilaterally between Hitler and Izmit. Unfortunately, it's not Atatürk, but whatever. We want him to have at least a good time before he, you know, can't. Cool. I do want to do counter-fundamentalist operations, but let's go ahead and pay off some... No, let's get rid of the Turks. Not get rid of the Turks, no, we are Turks. Let's get rid of the problematic Kurds. Just get rid of them. Well, I want to be done with them. Finally, thank God. We get exemptions from fighting the military? How dare you? How dare you? But this is, the price we have to pay for now. For now, we'll come back to the Turks. I keep saying the Turks, the Kurds someday. We are playing as the Turks. Oh! Military factories after that. So, we're going to go military factories, civilian factories... More military factories in Bursa. And since we're not going to be at war, maybe a few more civilian factories? Because 33 factories, with most of them being civilian. Whew. So at least we're done with the Kurds for now. And we still got a way to subsidize that stuff. I did that one just because we already are out of steel. I could trade for one more steel, but what do we need it for? At this point, we only have one dockyard for that. Is it really worth getting that? I don't think so. In the meantime, though, let's grab... Oh, every state that produces 40 or more units of chromium will receive 3 levels of infrastructure and 2 military factories. The Germans have approached us with a favorable deal. Chromium ore in exchange for the means to produce more military equipment of our own. By becoming the German Reich's primary source of chromium ore, we also become entitled to the German Reich's protection, which is quite an enviable position to be in nowadays. This would be very good. We've got to... work with everything that we've got, everyone that we have, whether they like it or not. About one a day, you know, it is what it is. Financing private enterprise, yeah, it's true, we're down here. We get a whole one civilian factory, big whoop-de-doo. But at least National Spain joined. How are we doing on guns? Artillery could be better. We do have 15 Army XP, which is not bad. You guys looking okay. Mountaineers will be very, very important, especially if we're going to be on the defensive, because I do plan on fighting the Soviets at some point. So we'll see what happens. And there goes the anarchist Spanish. Goodbye! It's almost 39. Got 2 months left before 39. I'm going to go ahead and grab... We could actually use Excavation 2 right now. Let's go and do that. Not Excavation 1. We don't believe in Excavation 1, but Excavation 2, that's good enough. Populism, huh? Not really worth it right now. Not really. You guys looking good. These guys, I don't want to hurt the amount of tanks we have, so just kind of stay in Ankara for now. Do anything for ya? Not really. That's okay. Military staff. I think we'll probably go with defense, because 10% more defense is pretty good. Promises of peace. Yeah, I don't think so. Political actions. We can improve working conditions for 100 political power. For 180 days, you get weekly stability 0.5. So in 180 days... Oh, man. Let's see. Let me, as I'm talking, let me pull out a calculator. Calculator. 180 days divided by 7 is 25.7 weeks. So it looks like 25 weeks. So 25 weeks times 0.5 is 12 and a half. That's actually not too bad. So if you do that, 100 political power, you get 12.5% more stability compared to 25 political power. So quarter for 5%. Actually, doing this multiple times is more worth it than that one. Because you don't lose consumer goods nearly as much and that. So four times this is obviously going to be 20%. So I'm going to probably take this one then. Improved worker factories, not worth it then. Better artillery would probably be worth it. Let's go and grab that. Since we are using artillery, so. Hey, you know what? We're doing math as we're playing Hoi4, you know? Give refuge to German scientists. 5% is okay. Yeah. At least we did math to figure out that, you know what? Maybe things aren't so great for us to choose. We have options. I love having options. If I have no options, I feel constrained. I feel, like, put down. But if we do have options, we feel better. Which is a great thing. Socialism, huh? More factory output, which is okay. Communism, eh. Daily democracy, meh. But we get more 50% political power for 75 political power, though. Weekly war support for 75? Ooh, we gotta do the math on that. I'll do that later on, though. Hey, we got military factories. And with Funk Plan, we get minus 5% consumer goods factories. Resources to market, plus 15%. And military factory construction speed, plus 5%. That's not bad. German military advisors, land doctrine, plus 7%. Turkey requests light tanks. The Italo-Turkish Naval Academy. Naval doctrine research speed plus 7%. Naval XP gain plus 5%. Starting attack and maneuvering skill levels of new Navy leaders plus 1. I'm going to go get the Funk plan so we can get some more consumer goods. When the shock plan was rolled out across Southern Europe, we did not participate in the scheme. The situation is changing. We are prepared to deepen our economic ties with the German Reich. German economist Walter Funk has drafted up a scheme tailored specifically to our situation in which we would be fools not to implement the scheme as soon as possible. So we don't have enough steel. I think now would be a good time to get more steel. We don't have enough aluminum or rubber. What we desperately need really is a few more guns. We got one there, and we'll actually throw one more onto artillery as well. As I go ahead, and where can we get some more steel? Well, it looks like we're probably going to have to buy some. Actually, can I change this? Oh, 150. Oh, it's so much. It's just cheaper to buy for now. At least buy one. And we'll buy it from the Germans, because the Germans, well, we're trying to deepen economic ties between each other, right? It only makes sense. A few more guns, as we're trying to build up more military factories, more civilian factories, all that good stuff. You know what, do that one first. You'll get done. 13th in January, you'll get done. 6th of January, and we just want to make more civilian factories as well. That's so good to do. That takes way too long. I didn't realize it took that long. My goodness. And we can do this soon enough to get more stability, which would be amazing. And we'll lose stability again, and political power, but we do get more resources to market by doing that focus, so that'll be very nice. Good, good, good. You need to train, go right ahead. Alright, let's go ahead and do this as well. Lost a little bit more political power, barely. Just barely. And now we have to pay off our debts, which makes us take on 15% consumer goods factories, but we do get more resources, and then we remove that, which would be good to pay off our debts. It's always good to pay off your debts. Do three more, because we still need more, and I'm going to grab one more from Germany. And 35.66, not bad. And we also produce these a little bit faster as well, which would be very good. Let's go up to 3 there, let's go up to 2, and let's go up to 5 for Cass? There you go. Something like that. Ah, the Funk plan. That'll be very helpful. But happy 1939, my friends. I know this video's gone on longer than the first, but that's usually what happens in the first video of my campaigns. I usually about around half an hour-ish. And the subsequent videos, I try to keep it down, but sometimes it just goes on longer, longer, longer. It's fine with me. Cool. Oh, just do it there. There you go. Political power. The Funk plan. What are we doing next? We probably should get guns, artillery, and industry. Those are the big three when you hit 39. My goodness, it takes forever. So after this one, invite German officers. Well, land doctrine is okay. Let's go ahead and get a non-aggression pact with the Soviets next. We signed a non-aggression pact with the Soviet Union in 1925, and we were one of the first countries in the world to engage in friendly relations with the Soviets, but the times have changed. It is important we renew this pact to ensure ties with the regime are healthy. We should get a non-aggression pact. We might have to break it eventually, so it's better to do it now and then be able to break it later if needed. Because I don't want to get attacked by them. Who wants to get attacked by the Soviets? I don't. Nice. Resources to market. Not bad. That's better. Definitely better. And we have minus one chromium. Oh, wait. Resources to market. Is that good or bad? That could be wrong. That could be very bad. Whatever. I want to pay off our debts, too. So after 180 days, we remove Turkish Public Debt Administration, which would be good. Anyway, actually, this is almost coming down, too, which is awesome. Things are looking up for us. Things are looking up for us very nicely. Actually, how are we doing here? It's okay. It's okay. Let's grab some output first, because we need more output. And then we'll grab some guns. Or artillery. Probably. Let's do artillery first, since we're already here. Might as well, right? Actually, what's the difference? So you have 25 soft attack for towed artillery. Improved artillery has how much soft attack? 30. 1, 2. 1, 2. Same cost. So, the same cost, you might as well upgrade them, right? I just want to pay off our debts, man. Oh, we can do... Let's go and do republicanism first, though. Even more stability. More output. Less consumer goods factories. More... I guess more political power gain. Awesome. Oh, look at that. We can actually invest and get more chromium. We lose 5 civilian factories, which I don't think is worth it, but... Yeah, it's okay. And are we done down here? We can't do this yet. Has not completed nationalized all private industry. The fate of Czechoslovakia? Cool. The Soviets agreed to renew non-aggression pact. We are delighted to report that there is positive news out of the Soviet Union as we have received word that the Soviet response to our suggestion of a renewed non-aggression pact has been very enthusiastic. Our officials believe that we can get the fine details, or the final details of the agreement, sorted out before the end of the week. A great day for peace. Good. That gives us some security. And I'm going to go and grab this because that seems pretty darn useful. We should work together with the Georgian regional government to enhance the industries of both our nations. Such an agreement would be fruitful to both parties and could not possibly be denied except for reasons that were explicitly political in nature. 2 civilian factories, 2 infrastructure. And for Georgia, they get a military factory and 2 infrastructure as well. Which, I wish we owned Georgia, but where we're going, we're definitely going to be owning them soon enough. Zox submits to Italy, so at least we get 2 more factories and 2 infrastructure in Trabzon. Do they produce anything? Well, that'll be good when we start building in there, too. Let's see. Ooh. Let's keep making... If anything, really, I want to make some more infrastructure. Keep civilian factories high. But at the same time, we're going to make some infrastructure here so we get some more steel. And chromium, but mostly steel. Oh, we can do this stuff now. That's good. I'm going to go and choose one of these. Let's see. For 100... Why is it 180 days for this? That's so ridiculously long. Look at that. Authorize the... Nuri Kiligil factory. Remove financing private enterprise. Change the popularity of fascism. Oh. You get a military factory for that. I prefer civilian factories, kind of, so. And Malatya cigarette factory. Cigarettes, let's smoke together. Hey, we're positive on infantry equipment. Finally, we actually have something positive here. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome, awesome. I just want to pay off debts. Because this takes forever. Prospect for resources, we could, but we're going to wait. Actually, this one needs excavation 4. Wow. That is a long, long time. Let's do one more focus before we end today's episode. I don't like that. But hey, look, 15 and 11, not bad. You'll be done on June 15th, within a month, close to a month, and you'll be done on May 23rd. Not bad. And keep getting us more resources. Minus 12, hopefully that becomes a little better. When did it say, so it's minus 12 for now. It'll be done on May 23rd. Hopefully we get maybe one or two more steel. Come on, one or two? Maybe not. Okay, never mind. We didn't get that much more, even though we got more infrastructure. So be it. Artillery, great. Let's grab better guns now. The Sten Mark IIs. We're not going to upgrade the artillery yet, because I want to make sure we get out of our deficit first, and then once we're out of our deficit, then we'll deal with it. 142 days. One more focus before we end the episode. One more. 13 days, provide refuge. We lose stability for weekly manpower. Nah. Antalya. We get three more military factories. That'd be pretty good. I think we might want to try this, though. The UK will guarantee the independence of Turkey as well. The British government has been anxious to sign an agreement with us. An agreement that, in effect, requires us to promise nothing but would compel the UK to leap to our aid in the event of an invasion. The whole thing reeks of desperation, but we can use desperation. We get better trade relations, Italy joins the Axis, we got more factories now and some infrastructure, and we get the basic medium tank, and we get guaranteed. Not a bad deal, I would say so myself. And we're making some of this good stuff here. Goodbye, cruisers. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. But that's going to conclude today's episode. So, should we acquiesce to the fundamentalists, or should we continue to initiate counter-fundamentalist operations? Let me know in the comments below. Now, I know you guys gave me support for both, for basically joining the Allies, Mediterranean Entente, join the Axis, or we could even possibly even do the anti-Bolshevik Mediterranean bloc. But your comments from this episode will determine which path we choose, because I'm fine choosing any one, two, three, or four, because in the end, where we're going with Turkey doesn't matter, because we create our own faction down there, and we basically leave the faction that we're a part of. But regardless, I hope you enjoyed today's episode. If you did, consider leaving a like, subscribe if you're new, check out my Discord link in the description below, and I'll see you tomorrow when World War II breaks out, and we will be continually building ourselves up as a stronger Turkish nation. Thanks for watching. Have a great rest of your day.